Hi, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and we've got some new products here that I think you're really going to like. Anyway, they're real DC water heating elements, and they come in all voltages and wattages. Well, several different anyway. We're expanding those all the time. We have a new one out that's adjustable, and it's, I believe, the first adjustable DC water heating element in the U.S., and we're the U.S. distributor for it. Okay, the first one I want to show you is these are beautiful. This is our new DC water heating element, and it has an adjustable thermostat built right in. Thermostat controls are made in Germany, high quality. Comes with a cord, about 6 foot, 2 leads. And there's the water temperature sensor, right there. Anyway, these are all copper, brass bases, and then they're nickel plated. And here's our other DC water heating elements, same thing. They're copper underneath this, brass ends, and nickel plated. Or you can make hot water with wind turbines or solar panels, and it's really easy. There's nothing to it. You basically just pick the proper size wind turbine or solar panel to go with the proper size water heating element, and you can make free hot water all day long. Okay, you're wondering what's the difference between a DC water heating element and an AC. Well, there's a major difference between the two. One is designed for AC only. The wattages are usually extremely high, like 1600 watts. And most of the DC elements that we have, they go up to 600 watts, like 24 volt, 600 watt, 12 volt, 600 watt. That's all you would want to use because it would draw an extreme amount of amperage to try to operate another one, an AC. So anyway, don't be confused when you're buying DC elements. Now these are true DC elements. They're the real thing. You can ohm them out, and they will ohm out exactly like they're supposed to. And I need to show you something here. See now, like this. All right, this is supposed to be a 48 volt, 300 watt DC water heating element. Company in California sells these things. And I want to show you the problem here. These are on the market everywhere. They're usually, they come from a company in California, and they're on eBay. Well, I'll show you what they look like. Usually $65 is the price you'll pay, and I need to show you what it looks like. Do a little up close. Okay, now if you can get right up close on this. Alright, notice there are no markings on the base, none there at all. Now let's take a look around at the plastic. These things are always marked if they are what they are. Make a close up of that. Okay, let's roll around. And we'll stop right here. Get very close, and you will notice that this has been melted out. And all of these elements are just like that. Notice where this is melted out? Well, that was done with a big soldering iron. The true numbers were removed. This is a 110 volt or 220 volt water heating element, and they're being sold as DC low wattage elements, which is BS, and I just showed you what you're going to get. So, don't be fooled by these things. Company in California sells them. And they're normally $65. There's one instance. Here's another type. These are all the same thing, by the way. You cut them open. The ends are melted off, so you can't tell what they are. This is a scam. Don't fall for it. Don't pay $65 for an $8 element. You can buy these anywhere for $8. Okay. I want to show you what to do with these elements here. Okay, all of our water heating elements will have the voltage, the wattage on the bottom, And normally they'll say SES. All water heaters, elements have to be stamped with numbers on the side or on the plate. Alright, this is just a little 110 volt water heater we picked up just for demonstration. Take the cover off. And this is what it's typically going to look like inside of an electric water heater. And this is all you need to do. Say you remove these wires here. Just off the element. You want to make sure that these things are unplugged, completely unwired. Don't ever mess with these when they're on. Okay, now I've got a tool. You can get these at any hardware. This is a water heating element tool. Really cheap. They're designed to go onto that element, take it out, and that's all they're good for. Okay. Now, take the element out. Now see, this is a, go up close on this. You get it up close. This is a 1650 watt, 120 volt water heating element. Okay, now see where that's wrote on there, the elements that I showed you, it was melted off. It's a scam. Okay, you take this one out. Simply take one of ours, screws right back in the same spot. There you go, it's as simple as that. Now you just hook your wires up to it. Never put AC voltage to these. These are strictly for solar panel, wind turbine, DC only. All right. With our adjustable thermostat, water heater, water heating element, it's really simple. Screw it in. Don't need any of the wires, because this is going to do all the work. It has a built-in thermostat. This thermostat is no longer used. It's just useless. Okay. We have our element in. Here's the adjustable thermostat. If you close in on that. Are you up close on that? Okay. This is adjustable from 50 to 190 degrees. There you go. It just clicked. So, it'll come on at 90 degrees right there. Here's your little stop. Adjust it to where you want. Okay. The other end of this cord is about 6 feet. Here you have two leads. Now I'll show you a simple way to hook this up. Okay. For instance here, we just got a little solar panel. We'll say you got a 100 watt solar panel. All solar panels have a positive and negative lead off the back. All you do is take the positive and negative, connect it to these two leads here, it doesn't matter which way they go, and put your solar panel off in the sun. This is going to bring your water up to temperature, and it will automatically shut off wherever you decide to have it adjusted to. That's as simple as that. Now, these water heating elements, people use these in stock tanks in the wintertime. Out west, wherever you have a stock tank that freezes over, they'll screw these right into the side of the tank. Take a solar panel, hook it directly up to it. That's all you have to do. Runs operation free. I mean, there's no messing around with it. Keep your tank from freezing up. All right. The good thing about having a DC water heating element to keep your stock tank or water tank outside thawed out, if you've got animals. If these ever burn out, your animals will not be electrocuted like they would from a 110 volt heating element. If it ever burned out and they got their face in that water, they're dead. So DC can't happen. This little area here. Okay, here's one way to hook this up. What you want to do is take these are the old leads right here coming in, the AC, disconnect these wires and get rid of them. Put one wire up to the screw on the element and say hook your negative wire from your solar panel here, just wiring it together there, or I guess you can just hook it right here to this terminal and hook the positive right there, and that's pretty much it. It'll just run on through, start it up. You can still use the thermostat that comes with the water heating element. It'll turn it on and off like it's supposed to. Okay, you don't have to, what you want to do is if you want a preheater for your water heater tank, you just get, pick up an old water heater, get one for free, disconnect the incoming cold water from your old water heater, bring the cold water into the preheat tank, back out into your water heater. Hook your DC elements up there, there you go, you're preheating water before it goes in your regular household tank. I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and thanks for watching.